The Bible is the mark of the beast. Today will be very interesting because we're going to be talking about living with sinners. And this is one of your hardest jobs, living with sinners. So pay close attention. I'll give you a few hot tips that you can be able to make it through this world surrounded by demons. These are demons, all of them. So we'll start out. Now, one thing you need to do is learn your enemies. If you're talking to a Catholic, you say, how many priests are in jail for harming little children? You know, and that puts the Catholics on the run because that's been in the news now. They've been revealed. Satan has been revealed. You know, the Pope was in on it and all of them. They've been doing it for hundreds of years. And they don't want to talk about that. So know your enemy. That helps you tremendously. If you know your enemy, you can put them under the rug instead of them getting you because you tear up Bibles, all right? Now, this one here, this one's very easily to handle. They'll come in your house, try to build a church, or they'll talk to you. You tell them, say, tell me about John Lee. And they say, they'll frown, you know. If they know their history, they'll frown because, oh, John Lee. John Lee worked for Brigham Young. And they killed 130-some pioneer women, children, and men. And they buried them up there. They reburied them a while back to give them a little honor, you know. And they don't want to talk about the Mountain Meadow Massacre because they kill them. So know your enemy. And Mormons will run when you mention John Lee and the Mountain Meadow Massacre because they got blood on their hands. Now, I want to tell you, she'll be telling you, showing you some of your enemies. These are devils. They make divisions in the body of Christ. They're not Christians. They're Jehovah's Witnesses and things. So, now here's your best trick, or your best principle. What did Paul do when they got him amongst the Pharisees and the Sadducees? They brought him before council. Now, this is in the 23rd chapter of your history book, book of Acts. So Paul got up there and he said, I'm a Pharisee. Paul was no Pharisee, but he'd been born a Pharisee. He'd been under the law as a Pharisee. He said, I believe in the resurrection and spirits. And see, the Sadducees, they believed in spirits, they believed in angels, and the resurrection. Paul said, I'm called in question of the resurrection. So what did the Sadducees and the Pharisees start doing? They started fighting over Paul, see? So the captain had to come down there and get Paul out of there because Paul used wisdom and put the Baptists against the Pentecostals. So he knew how to do it. So learn how to do this secret. This is the secret, and you really need to learn to do this. Now, say you're working on a job and you got a home and some children, but you love this message and you want to stay there, and people, they're going to feel around and find out who you are. And they want to discover you. They'll say, what church you belong to? So you say, Pentecostal. Because you say, Pentecostal is a Jewish holiday. Okay? So you say Pentecostal. Well, they got mega churches of Pentecostals. Well, most of them's Assemblies of God or Church of God. They don't like to put their name on it because Jim and Tammy Baker was Assemblies of God, and so was Jimmy Swaggart. And Trinity Broadcast is basically Assemblies of God. They don't want to talk about that, so they'll just let you be a Pentecost. Because you believe in Pentecost. When the Holy Ghost fell down, that's what we believe in. So learn to be wise. Be wise like Paul was. He said, I'm a Pharisee. Tell him I'm Pentecost. If you have to stay there, you see, you can deceive them easy. Because they're gullible anyway, believing a book is the Word of God. All right? So take this to heart and understand how to do these things and be able to, you'll make it through life. You got to live through these devils. We're scattered out. They're just a remnant of us Holy Ghost people. And Jesus is using us as a light. So we're a light from the Lord. And we have enemies galore. All these devils. They're all devils. And they'll take you under. Now I want to tell you the worst one you got. The very worst one you got. Is the one that believes like you. I had me a little Holy Ghost church in Tennessee, down around Jackson, Tennessee, back in the 70s, and people loved this message. The Holy Ghost was moving, but you know what happened? Some of these people snuck in unawares and claimed your message. Now, this is your worst enemy. They'll tell you, I believe the Bible's the mark of the beast. I believe it's an idol, and they'll get in there and get your doctrine. They're anointed by Satan. Satan will sacrifice a few people to get to you. He don't want this out in the world. And they'll come in, they'll sneak in your house. That snake will slither in your house and you'll hardly ever get him out because he's got your doctrine. And he's anti-social anyway. He don't work. He don't have no work record. He's a parasite. See, he lives off Satan, and he obeys Satan, and Satan gives him a pretty good life. He lives with others and lives off them. That's your worst enemy. Remember Judas. Judas took 30 pieces of silver, and he destroyed Jesus Christ. He told the enemies. See, they'll tell your enemies. You think they love you, they'll smile at you and agree with you and tear up Bibles and everything. But behind your back, they're trying to destroy you. And that's the worst enemy you got, the ones that believes like you. They'll teach that the seven trumpets has already sounded. They'll teach that Jesus rules this world. They'll put a little false doctrine in there and tears up the little ones. They'll destroy all your little ones. And pretty soon your church is gone. Now this time they won't win. They're going to be in trouble. Jesus is going to get them. Because he said, my voice will be heard again. Now they've snuck in amongst us. And there's many of them that claims they know what we believe and they love what we believe. But they're finding out all about you. They get all about you. They know all about you. And they are going to destroy you with your own word. That was the worst thing when I built a Holy Ghost church. People snuck in. They brought in a little bit of false doctrine. They brought in, I love you. I want to get the church together. I want to be part of the church. We want to grow. But they're devils. They're devils. Watch them. They're devils. They say the seven trumpets is already sound. Say, we leave at the last trumpet. Why ain't we gone? See, they'll say, Jesus rules the world. Well, why did Satan offer Jesus the whole world? Why is God going to destroy this world if Jesus rules the world? They bring in this false doctrine. And pretty soon they're parasites. They get in here. They won't work. If you don't work, you don't eat. They don't have no work record. They cannot do things. See, they are parasites. Satan sacrifices them to destroy us. Now you watch the ones that believe like you. The ones that says the Bible's an idol. The Bible is the mark of the beast. They will destroy you. They will destroy you flat out. They're enemy. Now all these people she's showing you is enemy. But you can fight these enemies. Because you understand them. Learn them. But the ones that believe your doctrine, you better really pray about them. They'll be trying to get you. Said, oh, I want to be part of y'all. I want to be in with y'all. Beware of them. Always watch them, you see. They'll be drinking them beers and telling you about Jesus. And that's why they are. They are sneaky snakes. The ones that believe like you. So watch them. But be a Pentecostal. If you're working on the job and you have to stay there and raise your children, you got ways that God will get you through. And they will watch you. They'll get your name. They'll learn all about you. And they'll destroy you. They've tried to destroy me for 45 years. Jesus will deliver us today. If you'll listen to what I'm telling you, we're going to go through. We're going to have this message out. And all these people make divisions in the body of Christ. They're of the devil. And they're our enemies. They are enemies of the cross of Jesus Christ. And we're the ones that's Holy Ghost people. I'm anointed of God to tell you this. Now, I know they took off John the Baptist's head. He was anointed to tell things. Jesus was anointed. Judas got him. But this is end time. The next two coming out. Do you know the two witnesses is coming out? And I'm not one of the two witnesses. I am a witness. Do you know they have to kill people just to tell the gospel? They have to kill people. Fire comes out of their mouth and kills them. Jesus has to kill people today to get us through. If he has to kill a few of these devils to get us through, he's going to have a light on the earth. Satan's not going to run him off this earth. His voice is going to be heard again no matter what these devils do. He'll sacrifice people, make sacrifice of, to get to you. This is bigger than you think it is. This is eternal life. He wants to take, Satan wants to take all of God's people, and God don't have nobody, and he makes God look bad. This time he's not going to make God look bad. We're going to make, there's going to be a lot of us, make it. And they said, whence comest these? He said, these comest out of great tribulation. And they got their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. And they're not going to get us this time because Jesus is going to see us through. So watch these devils. They're smart, but get smarter than they are. And you can handle them easy. Jesus will put Satan under our feet. And living with the devil, living with sinners, is hard. But they ain't tougher than Jesus. Let the Holy Ghost teach you. I'll tell you a lot more secrets, but I don't want Satan to know our secrets. The Holy Ghost will tell them to you. But live amongst these sinners and fight a good fight.
Memories bound. When the sons of God again put their hands.